Hello, my name is Terry Calico, and I'm the senior VO designer on Dead Space. In the original Dead Space, Isaac's breathing and heartbeat was such an integral part of the player's connection with Isaac in building immersion and emphasizing the horror experience. Breathing is a huge part of Dead Space and horror films in general that enhance the feeling of being alone and vulnerable. For Dead Space, we're looking back at the core functionality of the original and not only bringing that experience forward, but we're finding ways we can improve it to a level that exceeds expectations in today's generation of games. In the original Dead Space, you would hear Isaac's breathing change and heartbeat ramp up over time when sprinting, when low on health, low on oxygen, during combat, and spike for jump scares or scripted events. All of that will be there. A couple of improvements, for example. In the original, when Isaac was sprinting or injured, you would hear additional grunts to emphasize his level of exertion play simultaneously over top of the base breathing rate. Exertions, such as melee and stomp, also played over top of the breathing rather than interrupt it. If you listened carefully, you were hearing two voices at the same time. The exerted breaths didn't interject the bass breathing. For Dead Space, we're building a system that supports transitioning respiratory rates through fatigued and low health states seamlessly. As another example, in the original, when Isaac was gasping for air while running out of oxygen, exiting the vacuum of space or using an oxygen refill would instantaneously and unnaturally revert Isaac back to a calm breathing state as if nothing had happened.
Exiting vacuum.
For Dead Space, you can expect to hear Isaac catch his breath as he recovers from a lack of oxygen. Let's have a listen to this prototyped in-game with some placeholder content. And as Isaac catches his breath, you hear it transition back smoothly into the base breathing cycle. For Dead Space, we're building what is called the ALIVE system. It encompasses all components of Isaac's breathing and heart rate, vocal exertions, and dialogue, influenced by a variety of driving gameplay features. The limbic system is the part of the brain that controls behavioral and emotional responses, such as anxiety and fear. When you watch a horror movie or play a scary game, the limbic system can trigger a release of adrenaline into the body, causing a physical response, such as increased heart rate. In our game, adrenaline is derived from various values driven by external factors that have a direct influence on Isaac's heart rate BPM. External factors that act as adrenaline are the combat difficulty value, scripted events and jump scares, Isaac's fatigue level, Isaac's oxygen level, and Isaac's health. We want Isaac to reflect how anyone would physically react in the scenario he's placed in, and vice versa, use that to influence the player to feel the same response. For Isaac's scripted dialogue lines, where the player maintains full control of Isaac, we will have three variations of each line to pick from based on his current state: a normal version, a fatigued version, and an injured version. Let's have a listen to how Isaac's fatigue level or being in a low health state can impact Isaac's scripted dialogue in-game.
Nicole? It's me. Nicole? It's me. Nicole! It's me!
Making up Isaac's vitals are his heart rate, respiratory rate, oxygen level, and health. As Isaac is 43 years old, I studied average heart and respiratory rates for his age group at different levels of fitness to land on Isaac's base heart rate of 70 BPM to build up from. As heart rate increases, his respiratory rate increases as well. I broke down the respiratory rates into 7 breathing cycles mapped out across 7 correlating heart rate BPM zones. Each cycle also has fatigued and injured modifiers. All right, let's have a listen to how Isaac's breathing is behaving in game. One thing to note, the breathing and exertion samples that you'll be hearing in game are not Gunner Wright. These are placeholder samples that we recorded for testing all of this functionality out in game as we were building it. And here on screen is our Alive monitor. This is some debug information that we've put together to see Isaac's current breathing cycle, his heart rate, what his breathing state is, if he's inhaling or exhaling, what his fatigue level is, his oxygen level, his health, and the current combat intensity. And if we have Isaac's sprint here, over time you'll start to see his fatigue level increase. And when Isaac's fatigue level gets past a certain threshold, you'll start to hear fatigued breaths, exerted breaths, start to mix in with his regular base breathing rate. And when Isaac stops sprinting, you'll see his fatigue level start to go down, his heart rate will come down, and his respiratory rate will slow down as well. Here we have Isaac in a very low health state. He's injured. And when he moves around in this state, we start to introduce little winces of pain mixed into his breathing cycle. And what's really great about the way we've built this system is that Isaac can be in both an injured state and fatigued state at the same time. So hearing those injured winces, those fatigued breaths mixed in with his regular breathing actually sounds quite natural. And wrapping up the Alive system, we have exertions. These are single one-off exertion events that interrupt or interject between base breathing loops. For example, melee, stomp, hit reactions, and death. Exertions, for the most part, will end in exhales and restart the breathing loop back up on an inhale. However, the breathing system will have the flexibility to have the option to start the breathing loop back up on an exhale or inhale, depending on the content. Thanks for listening. I hope you enjoyed this sneak peek into some of the things we're doing with audio to make Isaac come alive.